this tutorial, it will be about displaying your bonsai trees in your home, or not in a tokonoma or in the garden as we usually do. And this is based on a question from Ruben, who writes to me. In one of your last videos, I noticed a couple of your bonsai were stored inside, indoors, and it made me wonder if you have any experience with displaying bonsai indoors. Do you have any guidelines or suggestions on how to do so? What is the different compared to displaying bonsai outdoors? When we are displaying our trees outside, it is mostly about having a pleasant view of them. It is about the growing condition. We are focusing on that and making it easy to work with them. When I set up my trees in my garden, it is mostly so I'm able to enjoy and work with them. But at a daily basis, of course, I like a nice display and not just put on a bench stored behind the garden. I need to enjoy my trees in the garden too. Therefore, I try to build some benches that are pleasing, making an area where I feel comfortable and can enjoy my trees, and of course, if I have guests here too. The big difference of displaying trees in your home is, of course, how your home is decorated, how the interior is, how you want to use your trees. And using your bonsai is probably the most important issue here. How do you use them in your daily life? If you go to Japan or you go to China, there will be a big difference in the way trees are displayed when put indoors there. The traditional tokonoma will be the way to show trees. But I have also seen in China just trees put on a table in the hall or in a living room to show them for the guests. And for me, it's also about showing them to myself so I can enjoy them. But of course, every time we have visitors or guests, I try to put up a tree in the living room or in the hall or wherever I find it suitable. And as you notice, Ruben, I also put up some trees at a shelf in my studio so they can be decorative there. The big difference is that I am not that concerned about having necessarily a Japanese scroll or a Chinese scroll to support the tree. You can also do it a little more loose, a little more Western stylish, I think. When I say Western style, what do I mean? Well, I mean you don't necessarily have to do it the Japanese or Chinese way where the traditional display is set up. It is better to have your trees displayed than not. Therefore, I prefer just to take a tree, put it on a nice table, arrange it in the living room or wherever I want to watch it, and then just enjoy it instead of only having them outside. You have to take care about light and watering, of course. You will not have your trees indoors for several days. For a weekend, 1 or 2 days will be fine. If it is winter time, you have to take extra care. Acclimate so the trees do not just come from the cold directly into a hot living room. That will disturb the tree more than it will benefit it. So then put it in from a cold frame first for a few days and then into the living room and avoid it to stay there for more than the few hours you want it to display. Having it several days in the wintertime inside the living room will disturb it and break the dormancy period. So take care of that in the winter. But the rest of the season, just put a tree up on your table, on your desk. I would recommend to put it in a place with a quiet background so you can enjoy the tree and the aesthetics fully. But there are no rules how to do it. It is just about yourself finding the pleasure of using it. I have seen trees in China put on a table with a lot of teapots and other stuff. And for me, that was still pleasing to see, much better than in a strict arrangement that is not always necessary. I like the tokonoma settings as well, but in the West, we do not have those around us unless I have a tokonoma in my garden. This is still outside. You can build that in your home too if you want to. But not all have the possibility or like to have a tokonoma in the house. Therefore, bring in the tree, put it on a table so it looks nice, and that's it. If you want to add a scroll to the display, that is fine. You can use an accent too, or you can just use an accent, a shitakusa or a kusamono, as a single object for displaying. The most important thing is that you bring it in, giving it a peaceful setting and enjoying it. How you will set it up is of course totally up to you and your taste, but I will recommend a quiet background using a table to support the tree, not necessarily add an accent, but you can use other items to support the tree, or you can have a plain background with some good light. You can even use a spotlight on your wall to add this extra mood to the display, exactly as if you had another object, a sculpture or a painting on the wall. It is the same thing, you're bringing art into your life and into your house, and that will help you enjoying, I think, and have bigger pleasure with your trees. Using your bonsai like this, taking them in your home instead of just having them on a bench in the garden, I think will enhance the beauty and experience with bonsai a lot. So just enjoy setting it up, try to experiment, and of course it is easier with small shohin than larger bonsai, but if you have room for it, go for it and enjoy it. Another thing I would recommend is that you keep the Japanese aesthetics in mind, and that is cleaning the pot, have a clean soil surface covered with mosses, not necessarily for your own sake in your home, but normally you would cover the soil because it looks at as dirty in the Japanese tradition, but it is not a demand. You can also take in a tree that is in training if you want to enjoy it and watch it more closely. In my opinion, it is not necessarily a full finished bonsai that have to display it in your home. If you like to enjoy it, then do it, even if it is in a training period. But still, I would clean the pot. I will use a non-sticky oil, and that is an almond oil, for example, so it doesn't have a greasy pot. Clean that up, put it on a nice table, and just enjoy it.